Welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. I am very happy to see you again. Last video we have discussed the structure of ear, anatomy of ear. And that video, on this video we have seen that three regions of ear: external ear, middle ear and internal ear. Actually, external ear and middle ear, there is no sensory functions, there is no hearing process. The hearing organ is only the inner ear, especially in cochlea. What about external ear and middle ear? These two regions just they conduct the sound waves from external environment. The sound waves are collected and conducted, that's all, and conducted to the inner ear. So inside the inner ear, the sound waves are converted into another energy by cochlea. Cochlea nothing but a coil-like structure which is present in inner ear. So in this video we are going to discuss the inner ear. What are the regions of inner ear? Especially in human ear, inner ear has two regions. One that is called membranous labyrinth. The second one is bony labyrinth. So two structures are there. Inside the inner ear, there are two structures. One is called membranous labyrinth, one is called bony labyrinth. This bony labyrinth has three structures. One, cochlea. Second, vestibule. Third, semicircular canals. So that these are the three structures is present inside the inner ear. Already we have seen inner ear. Here I want to draw a diagram. So this is semicircular canals. So three semicircular canals. So from this one structure is there. Here is cochlea. So now this part is called cochlea. This is called semi circular canal, and this part is called vestibules. So semi circular canal, this region, this region. So now this is the inner ear structure alone. So in the inner ear, the one is the semicircular canal, the second one is cochlea, one more is vestibule structure. So these are the three structures present in the inner ear. Actually, this cochlea is the hearing organ. It is actually hearing organ. What about these two? These two performs body balancing. Body balancing, or you can say equilibrium. So once again, human inner ear has two structures. One is called membranous structure, which is present inside the canals. This structure. This is called membranous labyrinth, outer portion. Whereas the outer portion is called bony labyrinth. The outer portion is called bony labyrinth, inner portion is called membranous labyrinth. The bony labyrinth again has three zones, three regions. One is called cochlea, a coil like structure. It is actually hearing organ. It is the hearing organ actually. Whereas vestibule and semicircular canal, it performs body balancing, or you can say equilibrium of body like this. So this vestibule, this region has two structure. One is called utriculus . One more is called sacculus. These two structures present in the vestibule, they are collectively called otolith structure. What is this? Otolith structure. So, cochlea, vestibule, semicircular. These are the three important structures in the inner ear. Now, we will see the structure of cochlea first. And then we will discuss about the vestibule structure, and then discuss about the semicircular canals. What is the function? That's all. We will see later. First, we will see the sensory hearing organ, which is the actual hearing organ. It's called cochlea. So, what is cochlea? Cochlea is a coil-like structure, or snail-like structure, 2.75 circles, 2.75 times. It's a coil-like structure. It is the hearing organ. So this coil-like structure, just I'm drawing here. So this coil-like structure, 1.275, that's all. So 2.75 coil times coil here. So this coil-like structure has three cavities or three chambers inside the throughout the cochlea. So like this here, here what happens? Here having three chambers, 1, 2, 3, like this. So throughout the cochlea, it has three chambers, three cavities. What is the significance? Just you will see now. So I want to explain here three cavities, a cross section. So I will make a cross section here. So like this, I'll make a cross section here. Now we see the three chambers. These three chambers, this is the in a cross section of a portion of cochlea, a small portion of cochlea I'm enlarging here. So it has three chambers, 1, 2, 3 chambers are there. The first chamber, the upper chamber, is called scala vestibuli. Scala vestibuli. The lower chamber is called scala tympani. Scala tympani. The middle chamber here, this small chamber, is called scala media. This structure is actually called cochlea. A small cross section here. I am taking this region, I am enlarging this region. This structure throughout the cochlea, three chambers are present. The first one is called scala vestibuli. The second one is called, the lower chamber is called scala tympani. This one, the small chamber, is called scala media. Whereas in this chamber, a fluid is there. This fluid is called perilymph. And also here also perilymph. The fluid is present. Whereas in the scala media, the fluid, it is here, the scala media, this is called endolymph. So once again, a cross section of cochlea, we will see three chambers. The upper chamber is called scala vestibuli, which is filled with perilymph. The lower chamber is called scala tympani, which is filled with perilymph again. Whereas the small chamber between these two chambers, scala media, it was filled with endolymph. And apart from that, There is a black, see this black structure. Here, a membrane is there, this membrane. Just follow me. So this is the membrane. This membrane is called basilar membrane. This is called what? Basilar membrane. Because of the presence of basilar membrane, it creates three chambers. Because of this membrane only. And one more membrane is there. The upper, above this black structure. This is one more membrane above this. This membrane is called Raynaud's membrane. Raynaud's membrane. So two membranes are there. This is on the base. So it is called basilar membrane. The upper part is called Raynaud's membrane. These two membranes gives three chambers. One is scala vestibuli, this one is scala tympani, this one is scala media. In the basilar membrane, here you see this, in the basilar membrane, some special structures are there. In the basilar membrane, some special structures are there. They are called hair-like cells. They are called what? Hair-like cells. Hair-like cells, like this, so like this. Hair-like cells, throughout the length of cochlea, in the basilar membrane, hair-like structures are there, cells are there. They are four rows. They are in four rows. So in the basilar membrane, four rows of hair-like structures are present. This structure is called organ of Corti, which is called hearing organ. Cochlea is a hearing organ. Actually, the basilar membranes contains what? Above the basilar membrane, four rows of hair-like structures, special structures are called. These structures are called what? Organ of Corti. This is called what? Organ of Corti. Organ of Corti, you can say organ of Corti. So what is organ of Corti? How it function? How it convert the mechanical energy into chemical energy or electrical energy? We'll see now. So here we can see this. Above this Raynaud's membrane, the red color structure is there. See this? The red color structure. This is called tectorial membrane. What is called? The hair-like structures. Just imagine, this is hair-like structures. So above the hair-like structures, so membrane is there. This is called what? Tectorial membrane. This is called what? Tectorial membrane. I want to explain this structure in a simple way. So actually in your textbook it was given here like this. So this is called ganglion, cochlear ganglion, like this. So this moves to brain, it carries the message to the brain. So this is the internal structure of cochlea. This diagram is given in your textbook. Actually, I want to explain this structure in a simple manner, in a simple diagram. We never forget this in our life. So I want to explain this. Just listen carefully. So now, here we will see that. So this is, already I told, coil-like structure, cochlea, the coil-like structures. Now I want to straight away, make it straight. So like this. Just listen, I want to make it straight. So like this, the coil-like cochlea, so see this, the coil-like cochlea, now I want to make it straight, okay, like this, it was cochlea, just imagine, this is cochlea. What I told, this is basilar membrane, this is Raynaud's membrane. I want to draw a diagram here, so now see this, this is basilar membrane. And one more membrane is there. This membrane is called Raynaud's membrane. Two membranes are there. So here, this is basilar membrane, this is Raynaud's membrane. I want to simple the diagram to understand. So this is what? This is cochlea. The coil structure I want to become straight now. Now this is cochlea. This membrane is called what? Basilar membrane. What's it called? Basilar membrane. And this membrane, this one, resinous membrane. This is basilar membrane, this is basilar membrane. Just to see here, because of these two membranes, what happens? Inside the cochlea, throughout the cochlea, so throughout the cochlea, two membranes are there. Because of these two membranes, now it becomes three chambers. You see this? One, two, three. The upper chamber. This one is called scala vestibuli. The lower chamber, this chamber, scala tympani. The middle chamber, see this, this middle chamber, this one is scala media. In the middle, so it is called media. The lower chamber is tympani, the upper chamber is vestibuli, scala vestibuli. Now, once again, I am repeating, this is cochlea, the coil structure, I make it straight structure. So, throughout the cochlea, there is a membrane, this is called basilar membrane, and the base, so it is called basilar membrane. So, above this, one more membrane is called what? Resinous membrane. So, because of these two membranes, there is, throughout the cochlea, there are three chambers, three cavities are there, just imagine, you see this, here, this is scala vestibuli, scala tympani, scala media. Now, inside the scala vestibuli, inside the scala vestibuli, and also scala tympani, a fluid is there. This fluid is perilymph. We know that peri means outer. So outer portion contains a fluid, that is called what? Perilymph. Whereas inside the scala media, so in the center gap, a fluid is there. This fluid is called endolymph. Endolymph. So structure of organ of Corti. In a simple way, I can explain. So throughout the cochlea, there is a membrane in the base, at the base tail. This is called basilar membrane. Above this, one more membrane is called resinous membrane. Because of these two membranes, three cavities are there: scala vestibuli, scala tympani, scala media. Whereas scala vestibuli and scala tympani contains a fluid, is called outer fluid, is called perilymph. Whereas inner side of the scala media, one fluid is called endolymph. It was present in the inner part, so it is called what? Endolymph. So this is the important features. Apart from this, we should know one more important structure is here in the basilar membrane. This is the most important. You see this? This is basilar membrane. So throughout the basilar membrane, just listen here. Throughout the basilar membrane, like this, hair like cells are there. Where is the hair like cells are present? In the basilar membrane. So this is the basilar membrane. Above the basilar membrane, hair like cells. So see this, this is hair like cells, hair cells. As you can say, hair like cells are hair cells. This is in four rows. How many rows? Four rows of hair like structures or cells are present on the basilar membrane. This hair like cells combined call organ of Corti. Organ of Corti. So what is organ of Corti? On the basilar membrane, four rows of hair like cells are present. These hair cells are called what? Organ of Corti. And one more structure I want to explain this. So see this here. For example, here this is the hair like structures. So this is the hair like structures. So above this one membrane is there. Below the SNS membrane, one more membrane is there. Throughout the hair like structure, one more membrane. This membrane is called tectorial membrane. What is this? Tectorial membrane. So the same diagram here. Scala vestibuli. Scala tympani. Scala media. Four rows of hair cells. This is called tectorial membrane. This is called what? Tectorial membrane. So just imagine here, once again, this is basilar membrane. This is basilar membrane. Above the basilar membrane, what is this? Four rows of hair like cells are there. Four rows of hair like cells are there. Each hair cells has small structures like this. This is called stereocilia. What is this? Stereocilia. Above the stereocilia, one membrane is there. That is called tectorial membrane. So what? Tectorial membrane. So the same structure I have drawn here in a simple way to understand. So this cochlea has several structures. This is the actually hearing organ. How the hearing process takes place, we will discuss in a separate topic, in a separate video. That is called mechanism of hearing. So now we are listening only the internal structures of cochlea, especially the organ of Corti. Now we see the organ of Corti in detail. So see this portion, small portion I have mentioned here. This portion is enlarged here. The same thing here, it was enlarged to understand the internal features in detail. So the red color structure here, it has given there. Now it is called tectorial membrane. Tectorial membrane. Now this is called what? You know that basilar membrane. Basilar membrane. So this is basilar membrane. So this is basilar membrane. Above this, hair cells are there. This is called hair cells. So this blue color structure, hair cells. These are hair cells. So apart from hair cells, on the basilar membrane, some other cells are also there. That is called supporting cells. This green color structure, they are called supporting cells. Supporting cells. Now this blue color structure, so you see this. Now this is called inner hair cells. See the same thing here also. This is outer hair cells. So apart from the hair cells, four rows of cells are there. So this structure is called stereocilia. So hair cells at the tip of the hair cells, some structures are there. That's called stereocilia. This is inner hair cells. This is outer hair cells. These cells are called pillar cells. Actually, this is the organ of Corti. The same structure. It was enlarged here. So this is basilar membrane. Above the basilar membrane, four rows of hair cells are present. I have told here the inner side is called inner hair cells. The outer cell is called outer hair cells. The hair cells contain on the tip of the hair cells. Structure is there, called what? Stereocilia. So above this hair cells, one membrane is there. This membrane is called tectorial membrane. So these are the internal structure of organ of Corti. So one more structure I want to explain here. In the cochlea, this region, the common thing. So here it was stopped. This region is called helicotrema. One more structure is called, this is called the apical part. So for example, this is the apical part. Throughout the cochlea, this is the apical part, end part. This apical part has a one more structure called helicotrema. In this video, so far we have discussed the anatomy of inner ear. Inner ear, what are the regions, what are the internal features, especially cochlea, three chambers, basilar membrane, resinous membrane, scala vestibuli, scala tympani, scala media, organ of Corti, the hearing organ. So we have discussed all these things, a lot of things about the inner ear. I think it is easy to understand. In next video, we will see the mechanism of hearing. Thank you, students.